Vigilant Halasan. By the left. Quick march. Halt.
What a bunch of pathetic babies! I've never seen a worse lot in my entire career!
Troubles, Vigilant?
You said it! They're a dagger for detail. Not used to the experience and discipline we get in Waterdeep.
Will you be able to whip them into shape?
I'm doing my best, but I've other duties to attend to. This lot might have to get by on their own.
I'd love to send them back to Daggerford, but we need every soldier we can get, even ones as useless as these. Perhaps I can try training them for you?
You're the hero of Baldur's Gate. Why not? Come talk to me when you finish drilling them and we'll see how you did. Dismissed.
She sounds a lot more calm now. I should talk to each recruit and then report back to Vigilant Halasan about how I did. The unit from Daggerford isn't up to standards. I need to drill each of the six soldiers individually. Okay. Garold?
You are welcome here.
You seem nervous, soldier. Let's fix that right now, then. Attack a fellow recruit and show me what you've got. Yes, ma'am. Slash, jab, parry, and thrust. Slash... Well, ma'am, how did I do? Isn't giving them confidence, I guess. You obviously have a knack for memorizing attack patterns. Have you always found it easy to learn and memorize? Yes. I wanted to continue my schooling, but when the call went out for militia, I knew my duty was to serve. I sense magical potential in you, similar to my own. You are wasted as a soldier. Train with the battle mages instead. I've always liked to study, but never considered wizardry. Thank you. I'll visit the mages at once. Once I train all six recruits, I should speak to Vigilant Gerald. Alright, tailed.
The fair folk rarely have time for small talk.
Well, get ready for big talk then. Good night, ma'am. Alright, soldier, enough small talk, since you don't like small talk. Take on one of your fellow recruits and I'll advise you on your technique. Right away. How am I doing, ma'am? You need more attention, more energy. You're fighting for your life as well as Daggerford. Thank you, ma'am. Oh. That will help greatly, I think. Thank you for the personal attention. I'll keep practicing and let you get on with your duties. Thank you. Are you attacking the tent? Deneen?
You are welcome.
Greetings, ma'am. So I look like a crust of bread to you, maggot. No, then stop trying to butter me. I guess let's get to it. I mean, these two, not much of a difference. Otherwise, you could take the drill sergeant approach. Let's get to it, Private. Attack one of your companions while I evaluate your technique. Yes, ma'am. And stab, and dodge to the right.
Your actions are as ill-judged as they are incomprehensible.
And stab again. What do you think, ma'am? I want you to get in closer to the enemy and stab with more intent. Try that.
If you don't mind, I think I can teach the private some tricks. You've got the right idea, but you're not taking it far enough.
Who asked you? You mean I should try to fight, well, dirtier? What if I kick low, like this, and feint it off to one side? Oh, nice!
That's it. Leave the honor to nobles. Fight to win.
Why else would you fight? I will, thank you. Pay no attention to Savannah. I try not to. Clavista.
Oh, it's a fine day for meeting new friends.
Let's get to it. Ready to go, ma'am.
That's the attitude I like to see, soldier. Show that recruit over there what you've got. You got it! For Daggerford! Yes. Two stabs in the thighs, one in the stomach, and wait for him to fall. How was that, ma'am? What do you think, McKin?
Don't try to fight like a big one. Hitting up wears you out.
I do tire pretty quickly during drills. I thought I just needed more training.
Learn to fight right today. Best to unlearn later.
That makes a lot of sense. I'll start practicing right away. Okay. And then we've got Morlis.
You are welcome here.
I understand you'll be training me. That's right. Let's see what you can do, soldier. Attack one of your comrades. Yes, ma'am.
Trouble sword first.
Arrgh, die, you dog. Die. I'll hack you apart. How was that? Whoa, slow down there, soldier. You're out of control. Sorry, ma'am. I got a little carried away. You need to calm down. Focus your attacks. Let's try this again. How's this? That felt better to me. What do you think? Much better. Keep practicing, soldier. Yes, ma'am. And then I think this is the last one, Hester.
You are welcome, my sight.
Ready to go, ma'am. Just let me at the enemy. I'll kill them all. I like your attitude. Face off against one of the recruits and do your best. Yes, ma'am. Which recruit should I attack? Really doesn't matter. Just pick one and hit them. Yes, ma'am. Would you like me to start with my sword or begin at range with my crossbow? Sword? Yes, ma'am. My weapon seems to be broken. Maybe you can train one of the other recruits and get back to me? Are you stalling, soldier? No, of course not. You little maggot! You make me want to vomit! Viconia, you look like you have something to say?
Everyone fears death, young one. It's the natural state of mortals. Shar teaches that it's foolish to chase hope or plan overmuch for the future. Death comes to all of us in the end. It's what we do in the moment that matters.
I can't see how Viconia would need permission to speak. So by trying to avoid battle and all that comes with it, I'm missing out on my life now?
Life is loss. In the end, we lose our lives. Accept that truth and move forward.
I'll try. Is there one more?
You are welcome, my sight.
I feel much better, ma'am.
Good day to you.
I'll keep practicing, ma'am. That's 1-2. Tailed.
Troubled times are upon us.
Good night. Tailed. 3. La Vista.
May you know the happiness of a warm hearth and home.
I think I'm getting the hang of this. And then, it sounds like an old lady. Deneen is
you
5.
You are welcome in my sight.
Stab, stab, weave. And the other one we sent off to the battle mages. So, did we...
it has been too long since Minsc journeyed with such a fine companion.
What a bunch of pathetic babies! I've never seen a worse lot in my entire career!
I've finished training the recruits, speaking of which. Let's see how you did.
Incredible. I didn't think it was possible to whip that ragtag unit into shape, but you've done it.
Took some time and patience, but I'm happy with the result.
These louts might actually have my back in battle, thanks to you. Here, take this. I don't need it, and you might.
Magic items are handy things to have. Thanks. Is that what she's giving us? If you ever need anything from me or these soldiers, just ask. We got chainmail. I've finished training the troops. I've trained all the soldiers. Vigilant Halasan was happy with my efforts and rewarded me appropriately. Let's hope it's special chainmail. It is. I am too far away. Commander's chainmail plus 3. Though the dense and dull spots of this chainmail show its use, someone has taken good care of the armor. Patches of bright new link show where the armor has been carefully mended. The lack of ornamentation or gilded patterns on the suit give it an honest look, as if this were the armor of a soldier who served well and honorably. Charisma plus 1. The wearer and any allies within her visual radius are immune to fear and morale failure. Wow. Unfortunately, yeah, that would be great. I'd love to wear that, but mage cannot wear. Armor class is only 2. I'm not sure if this is going to be helpful for anybody. Armor class 0, of course. Vaconia with armor class 1. But I really want to sacrifice that to have people not in melee range and in visual range. I mean, she can't wear. Nobody else can wear that. Sadly. Mage, thief, shaman. Yeah, it's basically these 4 characters. Yeah, it's not that helpful, unfortunately.
What is it? A simple matter.
I'll sell it to this guy.
An army marches on its stomach.
Well, that sounds very awkward. I don't know why they would do such a thing. Maldon Kor.
Aye, let's talk more fight.
Let's see what's back here. Who are these people? Refugees?
What is it?
The hero of Baldur's Gate. Thank the gods. We could use a hero right now.
What is it?
This battle will be one for the history books.
Keep us safe.
Fine night, isn't it?
What is it?
Once the roads are clear, I'm going to Daggerford with the militia. Maybe I can start over there.
Order is what matters.
I've read that before.
We're more than mercenaries.
We'll do Baldur's Gate proud. Would that the same could be said of the Waterdavians or Daggerford's militia.
We're more than mercenaries.
The way I see it, you being here causes more problems than it solves. Who asked you? Alright, let's talk to Maldon Cole here.
The fair folk rarely have time for small talk.
What is it? Nothing. Carry on. I'll do that. Good luck to you. Oh. I wonder if that's someone who might have more to say later. Belagarm and Thaird, okay. Yeah, I guess we'll finish looking around. See what kind of trouble we can get into with McKinn. There's Glint. Helvdarr.
Oh! Who goes there?
Aren't you supposed to say that to people outside the barricade?
Sorry. A little drink yesterday evening turned into a lot of drinks early this morning. I'm not in the best shape right now.
You look to me like someone dealing with more than a hangover. Is something wrong?
Aye, but I don't want to waste your time with my sorrows. I know you're an important person.
You can tell me. What is it?
It's... this is gonna sound so... Ah, hells. It's me lucky charm. A pebble from Mithril Hall.
Me lucky charms.
I lost it somewhere on the march here.
The way he said me lucky charm, I'm just thinking of the cereal. The old commercial. Well, he's a little more gruff sounding than the lucky charm leprechaun.
Oh, I've had the most terrible luck since I realized it was gone. I lost at cards. Spilled a full mug of ale in my beard. Probably die in battle now, the way things are going.
That's more of a Scottish accent, isn't it? Slow down there, though. It's skill that sees you through battle, not luck.
It's just so... Wait. The other thing that went wrong is I got a hole in one of me boots. My patron god is Marthimer Duin. His symbol is a boot with a mace against it. Maybe if I get some fancy new boots, my luck will change back.
I wouldn't count on it. Worth a try, though.
I'm telling you, this'll do it. I just need some good leather, and then maybe that quartermaster, Belagarm, will order some made for me. Could you help me out?
You have a pair of worn boots, if you could fix those up.
I heard a bear's been sighted around Dead Man's Pass, but I can't leave my post. Bring the bear's hide to Belagarm and get me some new boots!
Okay. If it'll make you feel better, I'll get you the boots.
I know you're an important person with lots of things to do, but if you manage this, you'll have a loyal friend forever.
That's an awfully long time. I need to hunt a bear in Dead Man's Pass. Helvdarr the dwarf lost his lucky charm and needs a new one. I need to hunt down a bear outside the Crusader camp and bring its hide to Quartermaster Belagarm to make a new pair of boots. Okay.
Oh! Who goes there?
It's just me again, Sapphire.
Sorry! A little drink yesterday evening turned into a lot of drinks early this morning. I'm not in the best shape right now.
There's a lot of people out here.
We're more than mercenaries.
We can win this battle without you. Thanks.
Order is what matters.
We're more than mercenaries.
Marching on Dragonspear Castle will settle my jitters. All this waiting grates on the nerves. Who are all these people? Are they all refugees?
Keep us safe.
If we lose, you think the Crusaders will take us prisoner? Not that we're going to lose, but if we did lose... prisoners? You think?
What is it?
I was thinking of moving anyway.
Lots of work to do.
Soldiers can requisition supplies at the quartermaster's tent.
Lots of work to do.
It takes a lot of effort to keep a camp this size running smoothly.
Lots of work to do.
Why are they all talking that voice?
War may be bad for people, but it's free for business. Golly.
The fair folk rarely have time for small talk.
The Crusader took what they wanted and left me in the dust.
Good day, and hello to you.
Greetings, my lady.
Keep us safe.
I can't get through. Nope, I can't get to them. I can't even pick myself apart from... Okay. Who did I not talk to?
What is it?
This battle will be one for the history books. There's a kid back here.
I want my mommy.
Make the Crusaders pay for what they did to us.
Keep us safe.
I lost everything. Everything.
Keep us safe.
I want my mommy.
Fine night, isn't it?
What is it?
It's good to see three strong forces working together. Well, two strong ones and the Daggerfordians.
Good day, and hello to you.
Yeah, I'm not reading the repeat dialogue. So, Waizahb? Waizahb? Is that who that is? It says nothing over here, right? I talk to these people. There's some militia people over here.
We're more than mercenaries. We're more than mercenaries.
I'll not turn my back on you when we march on Dragonspear. I know what you're capable of. Yes, murder.
Order is what matters.
The fair folk rarely have time for small talk.
Waizahb.
Your acquaintance I am glad to have made.
Greetings, my lady. In the market for a new weapon? Or perhaps a potion? Let me see what you have. It looks as though you might be interested in some of my special wares. They are quite out of the ordinary, very difficult to obtain. Are you talking about stolen goods? Stolen? Is it stealing when an enemy cuts off an enemy's supply lines? When an army cuts off an enemy's supply lines? It makes it harder for the adversary, breaks their morale. It might even bring a quicker end to the conflict. You're not cutting supply lines, though. You're talking about items stolen from the Crusaders, aren't you? Perhaps, but it's still true that a dispirited soldier doesn't fight as well. I'm simply doing my part to help end this quagmire. Fair enough. What do you have available? Sadly, I've only a few minor items in stock right now. I sell mundane items Crusaders misplaced as mementos for our own soldiers. There are items I want to get my hands on, but they're proving difficult to obtain. Everyone says you can do the impossible. Interested in making some quick coin? I might be. Tell me more.
Look at you getting into the spirit of things. This should be fun.
Oh, shut up back there. I'm looking for 5 things. A ring, a battle standard, a token of faith, a map, and a holy symbol. Oh. A multi-fetch quest. Tell me about the ring. A Crusader commander named Dreon wears a signet ring stamped with Kalar's seal. He's notoriously hard to talk to, but maybe you can figure out a way. I have a question about another item. Any particular battle standard? One of the chests in camp reportedly holds a stack of Crusade battle standards. I only need one. Too many will devalue their worth. What's this token of faith? Some new Crusaders have taken to making coins into charms, a show of their faith in the Shining Lady. One of them must carry such an item around. Any map? If it were any map, I could get it myself. What I want is a map that charts the Crusade's progress along the Sword Coast, annotated by Kalar herself. It hangs somewhere in the Crusader camp. A holy symbol different from the token of faith? Indeed, it's a symbol of a red knight. Looks like a knight chess piece, but with rubies for eyes. One of the Crusade's clerics wears it. I'll return when I have what you're looking for. Bring me what you can, and when you can, I'll be here. Waizahb, a fence at the Coalition siege camp, will pay good money for 5 items from the Crusader camp. A commander named Dreon wears a signet ring Waizahb wants. He's reputedly hard to talk to. I'll need to find a way to get him to trust me. A chest somewhere in the camp contains a battle standard. One of the Crusaders is a cleric of the Red Knight and has a holy symbol with rubies for eyes. That's sure to be noticed if it goes missing. I might have to find some sort of replacement. Some new recruits have taken to carrying homemade tokens of their devotion to Kalar. I need to find one. In the camp hangs a map of the Crusade's progress. It's annotated in Kalar's own writing. That shouldn't be hard to find. Okay. But you sell things too, though.
Soon to go back to the grotto, I am. I miss the tunnels of home.
Let me see what you have. I think you'd be happy with my selection. Perhaps. I'll determine that. Arrows of biting. Arrows are anti-magic. Detonation. Yeah, this explodes like a fireball, so it's very... Actually, it sounds pretty delightful. Oh, only has 5. Alright. Sunstone bullets? 1d4 plus 2 plus 2 fire damage. I'll take 2 stacks. Poison throwing dagger. The knight's embrace plus 3. A thief from Erebor, who feared being captured by the city guard, was known to have favored this armor. She designed the suit so that if she were ever incapacitated in any way, she would be rendered temporarily invisible. The armor did its job, and the thief had a long and successful career in the city. When she retired, she gifted the armor to her younger brother, and it has changed hands many times since then. Okay, so it's armor class 5, 7 versus piercing and missile. Anyone can use it in my party except for the 2 mages. If the wearer is rendered helpless, like by a hold person spell, becomes invisible for 1 turn. Hide in shadows plus 20%. This is armor class 4, though. And immunity to poison. Yeah.
The underground seems safer by far, and gems to find are welcome too.
It's pretty cool armor, but I would really only get it for the thief, and she has that one, which I like better. Raconteur's regalia. Oh, only usable by bard. I'll read this little story. When the half-elven bard Belaras left his home in Evereska, his musical tutor gave him this suit of armor as a parting gift. The brightly colored armor looks stylish as it protects, though it wasn't able to keep its original owner from falling prey to hill giants on his travels. Oh boy. On the breastplate of the armor appears a stylized golden heart, a mark of respect to Hanali Selenil. When Belaras died, a scar appeared on the golden heart that persists to this day. Pickpockets plus 10%, spellcasting is not disabled. So, it's only usable by bard. We don't have a bard in our party, so takes care of that. Headband of focus. Oh, this is for unarmed people. A worshipper of Nobanian crafted this gold silk headband embroidered with abstract running lions along its length while meditating on the teachings of Lord Faerûn. When the headband was complete, the worshipper found that Nobanian had rewarded his fealty by granting the headband the ability to conjure a surge of might within the wearer. Looks like a monk only? Yeah. Thaco plus 2, critical hit chance plus 5% on armed attacks, draw upon holy might once per day. Soft feet. Moves silently with plus 25%, immunity to grease, entangle, and web. These boots were crafted by a young mage who wished to be trained as a shadow dancer, but was turned away for being too loud when he walked. A shadow dancer weaves between the shadows and makes no sound, they said. You move like an elephant climbing a tree. Undeterred, the mage crafted a set of boots that caused his feet to become insubstantial, allowing him to walk with quiet confidence and avoid stepping on nasty substances. That's pretty sweet. Screaming bagpipes. Bard only. This deep purple set of bagpipes has an odd furry texture to it. Ugh. On closer inspection, the bagpipes appear to be made of the hide of some tentacled creature, with each of its furry purple tentacles becoming one of the instrument's pipes. When played, the bagpipe growls and screeches like a creature in pain. Sound bursts twice per day. 4d8 sonic for jester, 2d8 others, save versus breath halves. Deafens for 3 rounds, save versus breath negates. 15-foot radius around the bar, that's pretty funny. I wonder if it actually makes a crazy sound. Belt of the Skillful Blade. A blacksmith in Cormyr is responsible for designing this item. Sayan Keen Edge was renowned for designing the sharpest, best-balanced, and most beautiful blades in the country. She was also a bit of a hothead and grew furious when she saw less skilled fighters wielding her weapons. For her finest work, she handed out one of these belts free with purchase in order that her weapons never be mishandled. Slashing damage plus 10% bonus. Thaco plus 2 bonus with the off hands, blades, and swashbucklers only. Okay, so it doesn't apply, but it helps with a slashing damage plus 10% bonus. Is it worth Minsc having? Look at this. Club. Bushwhacker plus 2. Most thieves favor bladed weapons when striking from the shadows, but not all. Whether due to religious convictions, personal preference, or anti-establishment tendencies, some thieves prefer to backstab their enemies with a blunt instrument. It's not really a backstab, right? More like a back pound? Renders the target unconscious for 2 rounds when a backstab is performed. That's interesting. This belt, though. Taking a look. What is he using? He doesn't have a belt. Okay, that's perfect. I'll get that for him.
Your acquaintance I am glad to have made.
This will help with his damage. It's not going to help with the offhand thing because he's not a blade and swashbuckler. Can use it, right? Yeah. Now it's not going to show here, is it? Because it's like a 10% thing. Alright. But that's cool, he doesn't have a, belt, so. Still making our way through these bullets. One, really? One bullet of ice? That's fire. Ugh. That drives me crazy. Use these up, and then I'll put the sunstone ones in there. Really, 4 attacks, and we'll have 2 stacks done. That's a heavy cat.